guys. Welcome once again to One Coin Only. Thank you for coming back. I have had a quick bite to eat and some water, and I am ready to do part two. Well, actually, technically, this is part three. Once again, a big thank you for joining us for our VIP stream earlier today, too. That still counts. So we're now on our third stream, guys of the day, which is my new normal time slot. We're going to go back to the retro. We're going to do Double Dragon 2 and 4. And then we got a little Mario surprise afterwards. So this stream should be about 2.5 hours. Hope you're ready for more fun. Thank you so much for coming in. I'm going to say hello to everyone in the room. We got Gamer Dad and Captain BS over on the YouTube. And we got Richard, Como, Adam. And we got Corners of Yarn. We got Melissa there. We got Tim. We got One. Thank you for coming back in. Rick, Jason. Appreciate you guys. Let's have some fun, guys. Let's get back into it here, shall we? Let's load this sumbish up. And then Bimmy says, what up, Ricky D? Is that intro theme a mix of Shooting Star? It's not, but I can understand why you'd recognize that. You're talking about Bag Raiders, right? Man, that was such a cracking tune. I wish I could halfway produce my way. Yeah, that's... Wow, good old Bag Raiders, huh? How you going there, Daniel? Good to see you. We got Awesomeness Destroyer here too. Oh, thank you, Josh. Wow, there you go. That's too many big shoes to fill. I don't know how I can handle this, brother. Sumbish, how you doing there, Derek? We got Dustin. We got Seth. We got Wolven Films back in the building. I feel the need to constantly clear my throat at the moment. I don't know what's going on. Alright, so I'm going to do a little trick here. I've actually used a save state at the beginning. There is an exploit in this game where you can beat the fuck out of, as I say many times, you can beat the hell out of Jimmy Lee. And if you beat him to a pulp enough, every time you kill him, if you pick a two-player game and you kill the player two, you gain all their lives. So now look, we got 7 lives, guys. More chances to beat this game. I'm such a big cheat. We are playing on the hardest mode. We're playing on Supreme Master. When it comes to this game, if you don't play on Supreme Master, you don't get the proper endings. That's what we're going for today. Old Spear, man. I love the Bag Raiders back in the day, huh? So, Como, so you prefer the Master System version, but only... Yeah, well, that was a... You know, it's funny you bring that up, Como. The first ever Double Dragon game I ever played was on Master System. My auntie owned it. So that was my first Double Dragon game too, brother. So it's a very special spot there for me too. And alright, let's see how we go here. Yeah, here we go. Freaking, I don't know what happened to Linda over here, but she decided to get a pink haircut. Why'd you do that for, Linda? Anyway. And Charles says, oh no, you would have played online with me? Thank you, Rick, for the notify. Yeah, we're gonna have a good time. So yeah, as I said, we're doing Double Dragon 2, and then we're doing Double Dragon 4, the one that came out 2 years ago. The reason we're doing that is because Double Dragon 4 paid homage to this game. So they're both pretty much identical. That is not your concern, Daniel, but thank you very much for asking me. Hey, Cedric, thank you. Cedric is just, you am woken. There you go. Cedric with a $2 super chat. Cedric, this one's going out to you. Thank you very much. How you doing there, Reese? Share the stream, yo! Good to see you, Reese. Thank you for coming in. You're watching this until Ellsworth calls you back, you Mrs. Dan. Oh, well, Adam, thank you for coming by. I appreciate you. I do like Double Dragon Neon, but I feel like, its lasting appeal slowly dwindles on me. Like, a lot of these Double Dragon games I can repeatedly play and not get sick of them. When I play Double Dragon Neon, I feel like it gets a little bit less fun every time I play it. So, I mean, Double Dragon Neon was a cracking game, but I don't feel like it's got the longevity of some of the other games in the series. Just my opinion, though. Daniel says you're gonna try and keep me healthy. I can assure you, Daniel, that I'm on the right path. I've now got my paycheck, I can now do a food shop, and there's no more excuses. So I got you, man, don't you worry. And then One says you were trying to play Double Dragon Neon, but you can never get past the fourth level. I mean, Double Dragon Neon is kind of as close as you're going to get to an RPG in a Double Dragon game. You do need to grind and save up for cassette tapes and everything to build up your skills. But then once you do that, it's no longer fun because it's just too easy. Sandblaster Gaming says, this is nowhere near as good as the game you were playing just 30 minutes ago. Well, thank you very much, Sandblaster Gaming. I appreciate the... You're never going to keep everyone happy, right? Fucking hell. Thank you, Sam. Thank you, Kenneth. I appreciate that. And that helps me how. There is a lot of grinding in Double Dragon Neon. Yeah, no worries, Gomo. Sounds good to you, brother. How you going, Darren? Good to see you, man. Welcome back. No, Deadpool's in parts. I just, as I said, guys, I've played Deadpool for over 3 hours. And I felt I was starting to burn out from the repetition. And I was making mistakes. So I'm going to do a part two. I'm just trying to mix things up. As I said, I didn't want to just do the one game today. I wanted to come on and mix things up for everybody. As I said, some people come in for retro. Some people come in for the new stuff. I'm just trying to offer a little something for everyone, you know what I mean? But of course, in doing that, I'm going to piss someone off. How did the Deadpool stream went really, really good. We got about over halfway through the game, or around the halfway point, I think. How you going, Robert? Welcome back. That's a nice treat. We've got Robert over on the YouTube this time, brother. Thank you for coming in. And Richard, thank you for the kindness. Richard has just dropped a 50-star super chat. Appreciate you, Richard. Oh, crap. Get out of there, Rick. I'll be right with you, Rich. Let me see what we can give to Rich today, man. I appreciate that one. What do we got here? We got this one for you, Rich. Thank you again, my brother. Little Rocky Balboa. Who likes Rocky here? Then Robert says he's just trying to bounce around. No, I understand. April says, did I see your message on Deadpool? There are different outfits you can pick. I didn't see that, actually. I'm going to have to look into it. I'm going to see what other outfits I can get later on. Thank you for that, April. Do I think people would come in for a Final Fantasy VII full playthrough? I think they would, just because you know how to flow through the game really quick. You know, it takes me double the time to do that game than it takes you. Peyron, thank you, brother. Peyron with the 50 stars, and Peyron was all like, Emilio! Peyron, appreciate that. This is going out to you.
I'm like, Emilio! Emilio!
The club is closed.
Peyron, thank you again, bro, Seth. Hey, Cedric with another $2 super chat. Thank you. The Oculus Quest was amazing. You'd have to tell me about the Oculus Quest. I don't know anything about that, my friend.
You shake a pretty mean cake, Batman.
It's nothing. It's...
Thank you again, my brother. Jacob says I should try the Call of Duty mobile game. Maybe, you know, I don't want to get sucked into more of these freemium games because I don't have a lot of impulse control when it comes to them. And I don't want to spend, like, all my hard-earned money on, like, freaking tokens or garbage like that, you know what I mean? So I'll probably stay away from Call of Duty Mobile, thank you very much. Appreciate the suggestion. Good to see you, Paul. Thank you for coming in. Oh, really, Garrett? I understand. Bimmy Dean with 100 stars. Bimmy, thank you so much for your kindness. Thank you for hanging out. I appreciate ya. So Derek says, you don't know if I answered your question, so you can ask again. How do you get free stars? Facebook just gives them out at random, man. Again, Facebook will just randomly give you a notification while you're watching. Hey, you've got free stars. Send them to the streamer. So yeah, you only got a limited time to send them. So Adam says, how important are likes on the streams? Very important. So Bimmy, this is going out to you. Thank you again. I'm going to get into that in a sec. Likes on the stream are very, very important. The way we grow for free is with engagement. So the more comments we get, don't spam comments, of course, because Facebook looks down on that. But the more you chat with us on the stream, the more likes we get, the more shares we get, the more Facebook is like, hey, people are engaging with this post. We'll put this guy on more news feeds. And that's how pages mainly grow organically, is by people supporting the content. Which is why I push you guys, because I know most of the people on here enjoy what we do. But, you know, come on, we got to admit, it is easy to get lazy to not like and to not share, and... But that can be the death of a page. That's literally what keeps us going. So, it doesn't matter if it's me or another streamer on the internet. If you want to see them grow and prosper, all that engagement stuff is really important. How you doing there, Christopher? Good to see you. Oh, no worries, Bimmy. I appreciate that, man. I'm just glad we give you something you enjoy watching. Yeah, by the way, yeah, there's a star button next to the comment box. Sorry, Paul. I'm trying to get back to everyone here. And Matt says you hate Lonzo Ball. What did he ever do to you, Matt? I know who you're talking about. I don't know the NBA, but even I know who that is. What did he ever do to you? I know he's a colorful guy. I know he's a bit of a character. I know he said... I remember when he was on the wrestling, wasn't he? Wasn't the Ball family on the wrestling? And they said some stuff they shouldn't have or something? I thought that was a couple years ago now, wasn't it? Weren't they like the guest hosts or something? How you doing, Ben? Good to see you. Thank you for coming by. And then, apparently if there's no star button on your screen, apparently if you like the stream, or if you back out and come back in, it shows up. It's a known glitch. I don't know what's going on, but a couple people have mentioned it before. But yeah, sorry about that. Usually if you like the stream or back out and come back in, it comes up afterwards. So many enemies on the chopper. Yeah, man, this is like the TARDIS inside this chopper. There's a lot of freaking room in this bad boy, huh? Oh, gosh. It's like fuel for Facebook advertising. Otherwise, Facebook make you pay for it. And, like, you know, paying for advertisement is important, and we'll do it one day, but because we're still a small to medium-sized page, the amount that they want for advertising is going to cost pretty much every star that we earn, you know what I mean? So, that's why organic growth is key at the moment. I have done ad campaigns before, but not for a while. No, that's okay, Adam. I'm happy for you guys to ask whatever you guys... You know, I'm pretty much an open book. If there's something that I don't like, I'll be like, it's none of your business. Otherwise, I'll answer it for you guys. It's no big deal. We're here to be friends and talk about stuff. Well, otherwise, what's the point of a stream if I don't answer questions, right? Hey, go on there, Pedro. Good to see you. We got the bearded gamer in the house. Thank you for coming in, my friend. Appreciate ya. Yeah, a lot of people say that guy is like, Danny Trejo, but I think Danny Trejo would totally kick Kabobo's ass, quite frankly. We got Danny Trejo in this game, and we got Arnold Schwarzenegger in this game. Is he a good player or nah, not really, Matt? Do you think he lived up to the hype? Again, I'm not really familiar with the NBA too much. And so Paul says, how can you check how many stars you have? Have you purchased any stars already, Paul? If you've never bought any stars, then the amount of stars you've got is zero. But Facebook, if you click on the star icon, it tells you anyway. The star icon next to the comment box. Click on that, it'll let you know what you've got already. So then Kevin's asking me, what's my favorite dish at Outback? So you need to fuck up with that stuff, Kevin. We don't have many Outback steakhouses here. We don't need them. We're Australians, mate. We got home cooking and barbecues. Outback steakhouse. What is this? You're pretty much, if you're in the Outback, then you're eating in an Outback steakhouse. But you're not going to have an Outback steakhouse in the city. Not often, anyway. Oh, gosh. Kevin, you just made me so pissed off now. I'm losing. We just gonna beat these sumbitches. Instead of beating to eat it, would I consider waxing my legs and nose for a hair challenge? Maybe we could do different types of punishment in the future, Adam. I mean, that's not a terribly bad suggestion. I don't really want to wax my legs, though. Hey, man. It's like you guys always picking on me for Aussie stuff. It's not like I'm going all Americans live in a trailer park and go on Jerry Springer, you know what I mean? Like, I don't say that every stream. Like, cut me some slack, sumbitches. Oh, gosh. Do I know how to do the knee? I do know how to do the knee, but I always mistime it. So I like to usually stick with the uppercut, Charles. I'll be doing the knee in Double Dragon 4. In Double Dragon 4, the knee's a lot easier to connect with, but in this game, I'm going to stick with the uppercut. That's just my weapon of choice in this. But yeah, I struggle to pull off the knee in this. I can't get the timing window right often. I'll practice again one of these days. So Lauren says you want to try Korean barbecue. Oh, bro, Korean barbecue is the best. We're really fortunate in Australia. All you can eat Korean barbecue is pretty cheap. I love Korean barbecue. I had it on my birthday. But yeah, as I said, guys, thank you for coming back in. And if you haven't liked the stream yet, guys, I really appreciate it if you could help out. As I said, we're going to be here for another 2.5 hours. I may come on with a late stream. I just don't know yet, guys. It just depends how much energy I've got at the end. You know, now that I'm streaming 7 days a week, every week, I get really exhausted after 6 hours of streaming these days. But that's also because I'm doing behind-the-scenes stuff, too. But, yeah, we'll see how we go. We're definitely doing more than 6 hours of streaming as it is. Oh, god darn it! Oh, gosh! There we go, we got him. Far out, that bit really pisses me off. Alright, we got it. Don't mind me, there we go. I'm a little bit colourful here, guys. I use some language, I do apologise. I'm only trying to offend, not get angry, or, you know, I'm only trying to entertain, not offend or get angry. Anyway, you know what I'm trying to say. You probably don't know what I'm trying to say. None of that made sense. Oh, Richard says he's going to have some sushi tomorrow. Have they ever mentioned the Emu Wars, Ricky? That's probably the best burns you've had. Yeah, no, we get the... The Emu Wars have been brought up here before. I'm like, what the fuck, dude? Wow, William, that's a... Might move on from that question. So, okay, that's a good question. Adam says, how do stars equal money for me? So, it's kind of like Japanese yen. So, 100 stars equals $1 US, basically. So, yeah, 100 stars equals $1 US. And it makes up about 5/6 of our income. So, the fact that you guys have been so amazing is the reason we can do this full time. So, thank you. As I said, by the end of 2020, I'll have other means of support as well, and we won't have to rely on the community so much. Again, there's never any obligation for anyone to send star donations, but they do help more than you know. You know, I suppose it's just like a profession like any other, hey? This is like being the court jester, but like on a video game instead. You can call me the court jester of video gaming. Except I'm not always all that funny. You know, I can get better though, guys. I can practice. Who would win a fight, an emu or an ostrich? I think an ostrich probably would. They're a lot bigger, apparently. Plus, I think the ostriches are from more prehistoric as well, aren't they? I think the ostrich are an older generation of bird. Oh, thank you, Adam. I appreciate that. Adam sending $1. I appreciate that. Sending the Washingtons today. This is going out to you. Thank you so much. And I mean, see, as I said, man, they all tip, add up, you know, over the course of the month. It turns out to be, you know, okay living, you know what I mean? We get to improve the page. We get to eat and keep a roof on our head, and we get to give away better prizes, and, you know, it works out. Get to pay the streamers, which is always important. You don't want the streamers working for free, right? Oh, gosh, that's okay, Steve, that's not really an appropriate joke for the stream, brother. Can you... We've got ladies and children in here, man. We want to be a bit respectful, huh? Oh, we got this. Give me 1 second, guys. Couple more times. All right, we got him. Oh, there's two. Hey, how the emu? Oh gosh, can we just lay off the Aussie stereotypes, please, guys? Like, it's, you know, as I said, you don't hear me like throwing American stereotypes out all day, and it's just annoying. It's almost racist, actually. There you go, I threw the race card out in 2020. There you go. I'm pretty ashamed of that, but come on, like... I'm starting to take it a little bit personally sometimes. Alright, we're gonna take, you know, alright, we're gonna go this way. Damn it, I'm not gonna be an extra life shorter than I was hoping for, but we'll be okay. Hey, go on there, Corey. Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Appreciate ya. How you going, Don? Good to have you. Oh, not too much, man. As I said, you missed it before, Don, but we were just playing some Deadpool on the PS4. And now we're just playing some Double Dragon games. We're going to do a Mario surprise at the end too, brother. So we're just having a good time. Shooting the shiz. So William says Australia is one of the few countries you'd like to visit. Man, I mean, Australia has its ups and downs like every other country, but you know, Australia does have some really good people, and if you make friends with the right people, honestly, they give you the shirt off their back. Australian people are usually very hospitable, and the good news is the ones that are not, you can pretty much tell straight away, so you can stay away from them. So Payron, thank you again for the stars. I really, really appreciate that, Payron, with the chunky stars. And we also got $2 super chat from Cedric today too. Thank you so much, guys. This is going out to you today.
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained? Is this not why you are here?
Thank you, guys. Really, really appreciate that support today. That's epic. Have just avoid Mick Taylor from Wolf Creek. Yeah. I'm Mick Taylor. Pleased to meet ya. Yeah, exactly. That's what I mean. It goes for everywhere you go. I mean, you know, for example, Japan has a stereotype of, like, being one of the, you know, most well-mannered countries in the world. But that doesn't mean everyone over there is nice as well, you know, same thing. I really, really want to go to Japan. That's on my to-do list. May even end up over there before I next go to Thailand. I'd love to. The thing is, tickets to Japan at the moment, off-season, are incredibly cheap over here. So I feel very lucky I live close by. That's something we can think about later in the year. So, okay, William asked a good question. William says, what are some of the things I dislike about Australia? Well, obviously the bushfires, man. The fact that we freaking burn, it kind of sucks. What else do I dislike about Australia? There's not a whole lot that I dislike. We do have some of the same problems that you guys have in the United States socially these days. It comes with being in a Western country, but there's not too much I dislike. I'll get back to you on that question. I'm pretty fortunate. I do feel pretty lucky to live here. And Matt with the 50 stars. Matt, thank you so much for the kindness. Bad, this is going out to you. Thank you for the 50 stars.
Bad guy in a little coat.
I know, Kevin. Dude, I can't believe Wrestle Kingdom snuck up already, hey? Who are your picks in the main event? Oh, give me one second here, guys. Again, thank you so much for coming in for the stream again. Oh, dude. I've only been playing 25 minutes. We're already getting pretty close to the end of the game. And then Jacob says you missed SmackDown. I'm going to be watching SmackDown as soon as this stream is over, dude. Oh, crap balls. Ah, damn. There we go. We got him. Same goes for Idaho, you think, as well? I actually watched a video on YouTube. I'm very interested in the United States because there's, there's like 50 different states in the United States. And the dynamic is so different in each one. And I actually watched this video recently. It's like the top 50 states to live in the United States from best to worst. And I think the standard of living, apparently Idaho was up the top of the list, or pretty close to the top of the list or something. And oh, thank you, Paul. I appreciate it. I'm on all day by myself again tomorrow too. D-Wayne and Big Sean are not back until Sunday. But thank you, man. Appreciate it, Paul. And then Jesse says, do I enjoy detective story games? Sometimes. You guys have probably seen me do Deja Vu back in the day. That was one I grew up with. I don't mind the old point and click. They're not always streamable. You think, okay, gotcha. No, I just read the results about New Japan. Sorry, guys. I was just focusing here. Give me one second. I did see your comment, Matt. I just can't read out every single comment in the chat, bro. I appreciate ya. Yeah, there you go. Will Ferrell's apparently at the Lakers game today. Go, Uncle Will. Oh, yeah, we got Aussie gangs over here. Yeah, this part's like the worst, isn't it, Richard? We did it. Where do you like going to the US? I haven't been to too many places in the US yet. I've been to New Hampshire, I've been to Massachusetts, and I've been to Connecticut. Cedric with another $2 super chat, but I'd love to check out a lot more, obviously. Going out to you, brother. And do I think the classic point and clicks would go well on stream? Unfortunately, no, Josh. We've done Maniac Mansion a couple times on the channel, and it was just a little bit too slow paced for people. People couldn't get into it. We couldn't hold a room. I was tempted to get that Full Throttle game and possibly do that as well, but same thing, I think, brother. I don't think people are ready for them yet. I actually really enjoyed my time in Massachusetts, to be honest. Everyone over there was really lovely to me. I stayed in Medford with the bomb, and there was just a real sense of community there. They seemed to be all pretty neat people. Oh gosh, I'm trying to back off! There we go, we're gonna do this again. There you go, that's what save states are for, saving lives. I'm mistiming the uppercut, and that's where it's going to shit. See, at least when you play Double Dragon 4, it's a lot easier to execute the moves here. There we go, we got him. Come on, you sumbish. Bimmy thinks that... So, Maniac Mansion 2, essentially. Sam says he wants me to come to Chicago. Damn. Come on, one coin. Oh, there we go, we got him. Is that it? Yeah, take that. Actually, you know what? That's actually not a half bad idea. They'd be perfect for like a VIP stream sort of. You know what, Josh? That could work. And Timmy says, yes, one coin. Let the rage flow. Here's 100 stars. You, my friend, are the devil. Going out to you. Thank you again, Timmy. Appreciate ya. And one more time, guys. Please give us a thumbs up if you haven't yet. We really appreciate that. Shares are appreciated as well. Have I done L.A. Noir? I love L.A. Noir. Yes, I have. Both Sync and myself actually played that on stream. Yeah, we have done way back in the early days, though, not any time recently. And there we go, 50 stars from one coin only. Is that Robert or is that Shawnee McShawn-Shawn? Is that Shawnee McShawnerton? Hey, here we go. We got Voxy in the house as well. Good to see you, Amber. Thank you for coming in. Everyone give a big hello to Voxy in the business today. Welcome back, Bian. Good evening, Alan. Good to see you. Andrew Boone. Andrew, thank you for the 50 stars. Good to see you, Danger. And what are we going to give to Andrew? America!
I'm not allowed to stand up for myself? I thought this was America. Huh? Isn't this America? I'm sorry, I thought this was America.
And then Jason says, Ricky, if you come to Arizona in July, it'll be just like home. Actually, I think you sumbitches are a lot hotter in Arizona if I'm... Oh, gosh, darn it! I think you sumbitch... Ah, fuck, fuckity! I'm trying to get across here. And John, thank you again for the 250 stars. Oh, God, I can't get over! Can we just do a long jump from here? No, we can't. John, I'll be right with you. This is sucking! There you go, the rage is flowing now. There we go. Oh, fuck off! Oh, dude, I did that a second time. Are you kidding me? Oh, come... Oh, my gosh! Oh, dude, I can't get on that thing. Okay, we made it that time. Holy shitballs. I'm so sorry, guys. John, this is going out to you. Oh, gosh, there we go. Yeah, Voxany inspires me every day, and, you know, I'm not trying to embarrass my friend Amber here, but, she's 90% legally blind, and, she's still a successful streamer. I mean, there's nothing more inspirational than that, so, we want to thank, Amber for being an awesome part of the community. Definitely check out Voxany in your travels, guys. Oh, there you go, Sandblasted's still with us, good to see you still here. Kenneth, he says, yeah, we're hotter here, you wouldn't suggest July, because that's when all the humidity is also in Arizona. No, I feel ya. You imagine playing this as a kid and no save states? I beat this game on the warrior difficulty as a kid without save states, but I never beat this, I don't think, on the Supreme Master, which is the harder mode. That's just next level. Oh, dude, really? Oh, we got him. Is that it? I haven't been using too many save states, just at that jumpy bit. There you go. See, I'm making excuses again. Have you seen him? Oh, I understand, William. My bad. Oh, man, it's been a while. I do really enjoy that movie, obviously, though. So, Brandon says, since I'm a big Double Dragon fan, might you suggest Legend of the Double Dragon? It's a fan game, and it's a remake of Super Return of Double Dragon with style switching system. Oh, Brandon, absolutely, man. I'll try and remember. That would be a big help. Thank you very much. I'd love a copy. Yeah, man, we're always down for a new Double Dragon game. Absolutely. D-Wayne does a lot of Double Dragon game hacks on here as well. Alright, so we only got a level left after this, guys. We're finally gonna be done. Generally speaking, this game here is about 40 minutes long. Now, the next game we're playing, Double Dragon 4, goes for about an hour-ish. Right, there we are. Come on, you sumbish. Now, as you guys know, this game is also on our Beat It or Eat It wheel on Tuesdays, but, you know, the challenge is only usually 3 or 4 levels long, so it's nice to see the full game again. And Adam says, you see, Adam brings up a good point, and that's actually how I treat these games. Adam says, I'd rather see you play with save states so I can see more of the game. I treat video games like movies, and let's just imagine you went to see Rise of the Skywalker at the cinema, and then all of a sudden the projector just started looping at the same spot for 30 minutes. What would you do? You'd be so pissed off and you'd leave. I kind of look at game streaming the same way. If I'm not progressing through the same game, if I'm not progressing through the game, and I keep dying at the same spot over and over and over, people are not going to put up with it. They're going to leave and they're going to find another stream. So I treat video games like movies, and I try to keep the flow going as much as possible. Now, I'm not saying the way I do things is the right way. It's all subjective, and it depends on the community that you've got. But that's the way I like to do things. But, you know, some people like to hate on that, but, you know, you do things your way. You don't have to copy me. Anyway, we just got some notifications for some subs as well, guys. Dave, a big shout out to Dave, who's now been a supporter for a massive 6 months. Don't forget to click on that green shield, guys, if you want to find out more as well. And Dave, I appreciate everything you do for the channel. Did I ever find the Simpsons Doom hack? I didn't myself. I still need to learn how to hack Doom games, to be honest. Alright, let's continue on. Here we go, we got the final level, guys. Subs, yeah, I know. I do like a good subway. And there we go. Oh my goodness, Corey, thank you, man. Corey says, here's to another, great stream of Gracias, amigo. That is absolutely massive. Corey, thank you so much for the 1,000 stars. Do you have a favorite thank you screen, by the way, Corey? Because I'd love to give you something that you want to see. What would you like to see today, brother? That is absolutely amazing of you, my man. Thank you so much. Oh, no worries, Rick. Just fall off the fucking building. Oh, my goodness. There you go. The rage is coming out. This is the rage that you didn't get while I was playing Deadpool. Right, there we go. I just actually got the knee that time. Oh yeah, I've always wanted to do Chex Quest. I just don't know where to get a copy from. That's the one that came out of the cereal box, right? I remember AVGN reviewed it. They took away the seafood sub. Wait, we still got the seafood sub over here. That's like one of my favorites, Davo. You'd buy that for a dollar? You got it, Corey. I most certainly would buy that for a dollar. We're gonna buy that for a dollar right now, you sumbish.
Can I have your pole?
Sure! We've had our shots.
I'd buy that for a dollar.
Thank you so much again, guys. I've had a few people say that the star window is missing. Again, guys, I think all you need to do is like the stream or refresh, and the star thing should pop back up. A lot of people are telling me that. Is it happening with other streamers or is it just me? Maybe Facebook doesn't want me to make it because I swear too much and I'm a colorful larrikin. I don't know. I sense a conspiracy theory. Facebook, why don't you want one coin to make it? Well, what do you have against me apart from the fact I say fuck a little bit too much? I'm a positive influence on the community, Facebook. All I want for people here is to have a fun and have a good time. We're not about that drama. I like to try and send the kids a good message. Why don't you like me for, Facebook? What'd I ever do to you? It's not like I slept with Facebook's wife or anything. Anyway, we're gonna keep going here. I'm only joking, by the way, guys. I'm not really having a pity party. Everyone's like, well, Rick, that's getting a bit deep, isn't it? No, thank you, Corey, man. Much love, brother. Thank you so much for that awesome support today. We'll have to do another RoboCop screen eventually. Does D-Wayne still use his RoboCop one? I know D-Wayne... thank you for your cooperation. I'm kind of jealous, actually. That's a pretty awesome screen right there. I should be... Who's Facebook's wife? There you go. That's a question for another time, huh? Is that Bimmy Lee? It most certainly is. And then Oliver says Facebook's wife is pretty cute, actually. Oh my gosh, William. See, if you say things like that, then Facebook ain't gonna like me too much. How you going there? We got Captain Bill in the house. Good to see you, man. Thank you for coming by. Oh, dude. All right, there you go. Take that. Look at that guy just standing there like a total asshole, huh? Oh, gosh. You think you should go back and watch a RoboCop? I mean, the first RoboCop's the best, but number two is pretty sweet as well. I thought number three kind of went into so bad it's good territory because it was a train wreck. I can't remember number four. Probably for the better. I need to do a Tamako. Hey, that's not a bad idea. Once again, guys, thank you so much for coming in for another stream. Appreciate your time very, very much. More than you know. Now, this stream's going to go for over 2 hours today. This being our third stream of the day. Oh, we got him. Is that it? Alright, cool. So we got the last boss now. Yeah, and then Bimmy says you wouldn't worry about the old cuss word if Sweet Anita can say... Yeah, but... It's all in context. Like, I know it's a bit of a double standard with Sweet Anita, but one, she's freaking hot. She can say whatever she wants and she can get away with it. And, you know, she's got a mental illness. Well, a mental condition which makes her swear all the time. So, I mean, you gotta give leeway to poor Anita, you know what I mean? That's different. She's not doing it on purpose. I am, sort of. I could use tics as an excuse, but that probably wouldn't go down too well. All right, so what do we got over here? And then William says, RoboCop is awesome. Was the game any good? Depends. There's a couple good RoboCop games out there. Speaking of which, I'm going to do a RoboCop stream for you guys again pretty soon, actually. We'll do a RoboCop marathon or something. I'll play the good RoboCop games. Hey, go! Oh, that's right. He was too, wasn't he? How you going there, Bill? Thank you for coming back in, brother. Oh, excuse me. Oh, Dave! Thank you so much, sir. Dave with the 500 stars. Dave, before I give you a great big thank you, let me ask you, my man, before I forget. What did you have to do to get the star icon working? Was there a certain button you had to press, or did you just have to refresh, or what happened? How you going, Vanessa? Good to see you. Thank you again, Dave. That is absolutely massive. We're gonna pause this, and here we go. We're gonna dance and celebrate for David here. Oh, I'm 100% on her side. I mean, it's just people don't understand how Tourette's works, and that's why she's copping so much flat. She can't help what she says, man. Like, a lot of people think she can help what she says, but she really can't. She's not a horrible person. Was there a RoboCop rail shooter game? I don't know, RoboCop 2 was like part platformer, part action game, part rail shooter. So RoboCop 2 was a little bit. Thank you again, by the way. Hang on one second, shit. Oh gosh, guys, I'm all over the place here. All over the place here. Dave, once again, I want to thank you so much for the 500 stars. Just clicking on some stuff here, just making these windows all work. All right, we're back. Oh, goodness. So, I good to see you again. Ike says you'd play, for hours on, Double Dragon 2 as a kid. Oh, yeah, man. It's a quality game, isn't it? I love this music. This music is my favorite music, even more than the original Double Dragon theme. Yeah, that's right. We're talking about RoboCop versus Terminator. I actually personally think that's the best RoboCop game still. And Bearded Gamer says we should play some Jurassic Park games. Dude, we do sometimes. We play the one on Sega Genesis. I think that's the one that's actually worth playing. Dude. Jeremy says Tia Carrera is hot. Yeah, man, I love her. I saw her in a recent interview and she's still beautiful. So, yay Tia. Yeah, she is a kind of, well, yeah. Oh gosh, how you going there, Manny? Good to see you. Thank you very much for coming into, Manny. Hope you're having a wonderful day. The RoboCop games on NES were garbage. Oh yeah, all three of them were. I couldn't get into either of them. Again, AVGN did a big review on those too. Almost got this sumbitch. Just one more big uppercut should be enough. There we go, look at that. What a way to finish things off, guys. Hooray for us. Wait, Tia Carrera has a twin sister? Wow, that is something I did not know. Double trouble, I like it. It looks like my girlfriend is still alive after all, guys. We just saved the day and got the girl to the next time she gets kidnapped. Billy and Jimmy felt their revenge was complete, at least for now. There you go, so Marion's gonna wake up here. Bearded Gamer says I should play Hotel Mario on what? The Philips CDI, right? How about we don't and say we did? How about we don't and say we did? I think that's a better idea. Oh gosh. Alright, there we go. So there's that game. Guys, thank you. We're gonna load up our next one now. This shouldn't take me too long, guys, so don't go too far. And we're going to turn that off. I'm going to turn that one off. And which one are we going to do here? We're going to put this capture on. So let's see what we got. Oh, wait, I've got to turn my capture window on. Don't mind me, guys. There's a little bit involved in the setup process of this, guys. But, yeah, it only takes me, what, all of half a minute. So I appreciate your patience, everyone. As I said, doesn't take long. Play Mario is missing. I'm not really a big fan of Mario is missing, so I'm going to respectfully decline, my friend. All right, so let me see what we got. No, we're not that screen. Is that screen good enough? I think this is the one we need. This looks even. All right, we got the right screen. So we're going to load up Double Dragon 4 now, guys, on a different platform. And one day I should play Ninja Gaiden 2. You can play Ninja Gaiden 2. That game's too hard for me. Are you kidding me? I'm not playing Ninja Gaiden 2. No, one day we might play it. One day. If you're lucky. If you behave and you eat all your vegetables, we might play Ninja Gaiden 2 one day. How you going, Andrew, the old school gamer? Thank you for coming by. Now let me know how the sound is, guys. Just want to make sure it's not too loud for you before we get too far in. Everyone's asking me for all those obscure Mario games. I don't even know how to play those sumbitches, huh? If I play PS2's Playboy the Mansion game, I'll probably get booted. You're right. We do every single one of those games, Andrew. Every single one of those games we play. And that too. We play all that stuff. No, I'm not playing Sonic 06. Alright, let's go. So as you guys can see, this is just like, just like Double Dragon 2 The Revenge. It's a lot easier to pull off the special moves in this, so it's really awesome. See, it's very easy to do the knee here now. I still prefer the uppercut over the knee, however. Now, the controls in this compared to the other game we did are a little bit more floaty, so I'm just getting used to it. Yeah, they are a bit more floaty on this one. Still a fun game, though. This kind of got shunned by the critics. But I think this, personally, is a very fun Double Dragon game. I don't care what people say. Or the guy game on PS2 will get you banned. Oh, yeah, that's... and probably a lawsuit as well, that one. And a lawsuit. And Thurin says, oh, thank you, man. I appreciate the support, bro. A little encouragement goes a long way, man. Honestly, the encouragement's what keeps us going more than anything, so thank you. We got Rhonda. Good to see you, Rhonda. It's been a little minute. Thank you for hanging out with us, my friend. I hope you're doing well. And then Vanessa says, Boom Blocks 1 and 2 your favorite. You hope they make them on Switch. I don't even remember those games. Anyone else play Boom Blocks before? So Kevin says, is this a separate game on the Switch? Yeah, this game is on the Switch. It's on the PS4 and it's on the Xbox as well, guys. So you can get this on all modern consoles. It's only a couple dollars these days, I think. Is it possible that developers would ever start making games for the older system? Yeah, absolutely. There is a big resurgence at the moment of like retro gaming culture. And you're seeing that now with all the minis that are coming out, William. So yeah, man, absolutely. I think the big thing about these retro games consoles is, like, the parents have now got something to bond with their kids with. Like, my sister, for example, she's got a mini. And, you know, my sister would be like, okay, this is the Mario that we used to play when we were young. And, my niece and nephews love it, you know. Yeah, I'd like to do Mad World one day, actually. I remember that game. Andrew says, you've got two modded original Xboxes. I've still got a modded original Xbox, man. They're the bomb, aren't they? I love it. Abobo uses that Ric Flair chop. Yeah, man, you don't want to mess with Abobo in this game. He's a million times harder than the other ones. Like, he's got all sorts of special moves now. Thank you, Rhonda. I appreciate that. Yeah, likes and shares are incredibly valuable here, guys. Thank you for your time. Man, games just need to be fun to play. Sometimes, Jesse, less really is more, huh? And Jesse says, did I hear about the Nintendo 64 mini system? Ah, bro, as far as I hear, it's still rumored, Jesse. I think we'll probably get the Nintendo 64 mini. I'd love to see it. Do you think we'll ever get a GameCube mini? I'd love a GameCube mini. There were so many good games on that. Andrew says, do I like Lethal Enforcers on Genesis? Yes, sir, I do. We sometimes stream Lethal Enforcers on the channel. What game would you like to see a complete remake of? And Oliver says his is Scarface on the PS2. I'd like to see that as well. But I think the reality is that the licensing cost would be too big. I would like to see a Rocky franchise remake. Like, you know, Rocky Legends with better cutscenes and motion capture and... I'd love to see another Rocky game, actually, myself. That might surprise a few people. Yeah, I know, Kevin. You're telling me, bro. I had a look for it. Drew with the 50 stars. Thank you, game, mate. Drew says, you're a great streamer, Ricky. Much love. I appreciate that, man. Thank you so much for the encouragement, sir. 50 stars from Drew. I'll be right with you, brother. You're right with you, my man. So Drew with the 50 stars, what are we going to give to Drew? I'm going to give you this one. Now, how you doing today, Drew, anyway? What do you got planned over the weekend? That's a question for everyone, by the way. What's everyone doing this weekend? All right, we're going to continue on here. You can mod a Wii to play all games with a USB pretty easily. My dad's wife had a modded Wii. I don't know whatever happened to it, though. She did it when they were back in Thailand. And but then when you go over there, or to a lot of Southeast Asian countries, you know, the piracy laws over there are a lot more laxed. Like, you can pretty much pay off the authorities over there, so they'll mod anything for you. It's pretty awesome. You go to Thailand and you're like, I want this, this, and this, and they take you to like a secret back room. And one time I was really scared because I thought I was gonna get like gagged and blindfolded or something, but yeah. And playing a poker tournament on Sunday. Nice, Jessup. And you got a channel name for a tutorial? Oh, so you can hack the Vita now. That's pretty cool. Yeah, right back at you, Rhonda. And Matt says he's going to watch the NFL playoffs. And Andrew says he's just going to play some video games. Oh, I wouldn't take the chance on a PS4, you know, with the security that Sony have got these days. Yeah, no, I'd advise against it. Yeah, it looks like it gets... Alright, well, let's keep going here. Billy and Jimmy jumped on top of the speeding truck. Alright, mission number 3. Drew says you got to work and try to redo your streaming setup, find out what went wrong. What ended up happening? Did you have problems with your microphone or something? Might just need to play around with your sound settings or something. We got Black Eagle. Good to see you, Black Eagle. Welcome to the stream. Thank you so much for coming in, my friend. And Lauren says he likes the look to this. Yeah, man, again, as I said, if you want to get this on a modern console, it's only a couple bucks now. Good to have you, Lauren. And Jake says, how you been, Ricky? Jake, I'm doing okay, man. I think force positivity is like irresponsible, because I don't want to be like, oh, everything's perfect, I'm fantastic all the time, blah blah blah, because everyone thinks they have to be perfect all the time then, and they get depressed. And you know, it's just, I'm gonna be very, very real. You know, I'd say about 75-80% of myself, pretty good. You know, everything's going well with one coin, but you know, I'm also a little bit stressed out, and you know, just gotta work at schedule my time better. And you know, just working on that life balance side of things. But apart from that, I am doing really, really good, thank you, my friend. See, that's an honest answer. You know, that's not someone going, oh, my life is perfect and blah, blah, this and blah, blah, that. You can still be positive and be honest. Anyway, I don't know, I'm getting a bit deep here now, aren't I? How you going there, Joseph? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. The Pudsley Scavenger Hunt NES is $50 and up. Was that even any good? I remember reading about that game in Nintendo Magazine and saw it got a real bad score, so I never played it as a kid. I know what it is. Has anyone ever played an Addams Family game that they actually like? Oh, good night to you too, Andrew. You take care of yourself, man. Thank you for coming by. I don't know who this Mason guy is supposed to be in Double Dragon, but while he goes talky-talky, I'm just having a drink. Yeah, me too, Graz. You know, the irony is, and the unfortunate irony, Graz, is it doesn't rain in Queensland that often, but we're getting the rain, and now we're not the ones that need it. I mean, not for that sense. I'm glad the farmers, at least, are getting some relief. Aussie farmers in Queensland are always doing it tough. There we go, we gotcha. So there you go. It sounds so how much of a break are you gonna have, Don? Yeah, I'm glad too, man. You work long hours. You're always telling me how long you work. How you going there, Manny? Good to see you. Thank you for coming by. Share the stream, yo! Plag, plag! Oh, I don't dig Festus. Festus Quest. Oh my gosh, really? I know there's some people that really like Festus Quest. I guess I see the appeal, but I mean, most people find it incredibly frustrating. And Brittany has just sent the 420 stars. There you go. Brittany, thank you for coming in. We've got the very lovely Southern Bell Gaming in the house. What are we going to give to Brittany today? There you go. Excuse me, Princess. How you doing, Brit? Southern Bell, tell us what's going on. What's happening on your page these days? You know the rules, Brittany. You're supposed to come in as your page so we can plug you. We want to get you some followers, girl. How you going there, Tommy? Good to see you. Welcome in. And then, and Grass says you can't share Facebook. Oh, that's okay, man. It's all good. 81 shares already is fantastic. So thank you to everyone who has shared. Again, the best help you can give us is with a simple like. Only takes 2 seconds. And don't forget, guys, after this game is done, I've got a Mario surprise as well. So, it's a Mario game I've done before, but it's still a nice little gimmick. Don says 2 days, but you're getting a new kitchen cabinet this Saturday. And that night, your buddy and you are putting them up. I mean, it'd be nice to get that over with, though. Maybe just get your buddy to do it and you have the beers. That's not very nice, is it? Well, hopefully it doesn't take too long. You think Adam's Family for Amiga and Super Nintendo is pretty good? I used to rent out Adam's Family on the NES. And I have to admit, when I was a kid, I really enjoyed that game. But I go back and try to play Adam's Family on the NES now, and I don't find it all that much fun anymore. Jeez, man! Oh my gosh! This guy thinks he's fucking Brock Lesnar! Oh wait, I don't remember the last time Brock Lesnar splashed anyone. I'm just trying to get my point across. Holy shit, man! This guy is a freaking nut job. Oh, come on. Get that prick. Alright, we... There we go, we got him. Did I do Double Dragon? I didn't feel like doing Double Dragon 1 today, Black Eagle. I just felt like doing the number 2 and 4 today, so that's what we did. Oh, goodness. There we go, we're gonna send that. Yeah, exactly, Don. I mean, why not? Just make sure you shout him the beers as well, and then you're fine. Theron says you rented the Festus game. I can't remember if it was ever released over here. In Australia, a lot of those LJN games didn't all get released. Like, I don't think we got Friday the 13th and Beetlejuice and stuff like that. If we did, I never saw them. Yeah, happy birthday to you, by the way, Jake. Great way to end the birthday relaxing with no modding. I appreciate you, Jake. Jake, I hope you have a wonderful 2020 as well. And I hope you've had a blessed birthday. Everyone say a big happy birthday to Jake. I would have been, oh yeah, that's right. When he did the freaking shooting star press, that was a freaking dumb idea, wasn't it? That was Michael Hayes' idea as well, wasn't it? If I'm not mistaken, Kevin. I bet he had a lot to answer for afterwards. I'm pretty sure that was Michael Hayes' idea for Brock to do that. So Tommy says, you heard that John Morrison is back? Yeah, it would be interesting to see what role he plays in the Royal Rumble, huh? Anyway, no SmackDown spoilers, please, guys, because I've got to watch the show still. I'm going to be watching it after the stream is done. And Timmy with another 100 stars. Timmy, thank you, man. I really appreciate that. What are we going to give to Timmy this time? Oh, yeah! Thank you, Timmy. Timmy with a big 100, man. Thank you for everything you do again. I like that song too, Matthew. It's a classic. That Rockwell song, Somebody's Watching Me. In the 90s, DJ Bobo did a dance remix, which I really liked as well. So that is a really good song. And then Ministry of Sound brought out a version in the 2000s too, with Michael Jackson. Well, like, it was like with a midget playing Michael Jackson. I'm not allowed to say that, am I? Well, you know what I'm trying to say. A little person, whatever the freaking appropriate term is. Jeez. I'll be right... Oh, gosh, man. Be right with you guys. Hold up. Wait a minute. Dude. I can't believe we're still in our first credits. An absolute... Oh, well, that's not going to last for too long, is it? We got him. Come on, you sumbish. Oh, I see, Kevin. Yeah, I mean, when you're doing it in developmental, you have a... When everyone does those big flippity-flip-flip things in developmental, they're always landing on a mat. And Black Eagle says, have I ever played World of Warcraft back in the day? Yeah, dude, I have. Not for a while. Again, I do really enjoy MMOs. And part of me was very, very tempted to get back into Elder Scrolls Online. But, you know, being a full-time streamer and all that, it would not be in my best interest to get stuck into an MMO. Otherwise, I'd never get any streams or work done, you know what I mean? So... You know, for the greater good, I have to sacrifice my MMO time now, so maybe one day I'll do MMOs again. What's everyone's... Is anyone else here into MMOs? What's your favorite? You think the PC term is snack sized? Wow. Well, I guess maybe. Yeah, we got a little bit of a problem in Australia now. Most Australians are not politically correct. But the media is trying to make us politically correct, and that's kind of starting to piss me off. Like shows like A Current Affair and all that garbage, for example. Oh, there you go. Raymond likes Phantasy Star Online. Oh, very nice, Theron. Okay, thank you very much, John. I just read that. All right, I'll have a look for it. Thank you for reminding me. Don says he likes any Diablo game. Yeah, I like Diablo. Technically, that's... I guess technically Diablo is an MMO. Like, it's just a run of the... I mean, because you can just keep doing the same missions over and over, looting, and... I guess it's got some light MMO elements. I never really considered Diablo to be an MMO. But I suppose technically it is a little... I don't know. I don't know. I'm torn on that one, actually. I mean, maybe in a small way it's very similar. I don't know. Don, you've got me stuck. I'm going to leave that one. That's going to... Yeah. Yeah, I like Diablo. I still like the second one better. I hope we get a re-release of number 2 one day. I think 3 is great. But I would still rather go back and play 2. What about you, Graz? Which one do you like the best? There you go. I was overthinking that then, wasn't I? Oh, okay. That's it. 8 Eyes. There you go. That's an interesting one. That's a cool game. Yeah, nice. Good for you, Peyron. Are they all expensive games or... What kind of price are you looking at for those bad boys? Shit happens, I know. Wow, we're still doing alright. We already used a credit, didn't we? Why don't I ask Siri? Hey Siri, is Diablo an MMO? I don't know anything about that. I'll be like, shut up, Siri. Now, hang on one sec. Yeah, but by the way, guys, if you know any MMO... Not MMO groups, any Double Dragon groups or NES groups, now's a good time to share, yo. We'll get a lot of people come in and they'll be like, what's this? I've never seen this Double Dragon game before. Then I can introduce people to this game, you know, for the very first time. See, I'm doing a community service now. Yeah, you like that. Diablo, as I said, Diablo, maybe it's just nostalgia for me. I don't know, but I love Diablo 2. I love that the servers for Diablo 1 are back online now, too. That's pretty great. Oh, dude, man, he's caught... I've never had so many problems before from a regular minion. There we go, we got him. Over here we should... Hey, look, the bomb's online. I wonder what Jeff is doing. Hi, Jeff. I see you going online there. Yeah, I think that's pretty accurate, Josh. It's easy to confuse it with an MMO because there's like rifts and constant things you can do every day in that game and seasons and... But at the end of the day, it's not an MMO, is it? You're right. I think you're right. Tell Siri I go for Team Alexa. I actually said that to Siri. We said something along the lines to Siri like that the other day. And she gave us like a very diplomatic answer, like a very political answer. It's like she didn't want to get herself in trouble. It's all right, Siri. We know you're being a fake bish. We know what you really think. We all know that she wants to stab Alexa in her sleep. Oh, there you go. You want them to remake Diablo 1 with today's graphics. Hey, man, I could handle that. I love number 1 as well. I think number 1 is also a phenomenal game. We'll be stream... Oh, fuck off! Are you kidding me? We'll stream number 1 again in the future as well. That really pissed me off. Wow. Dude. See, unfortunately, this game does have a couple cheap deaths. And in typical beat-em-up fashion, these sons of bitches walk off the screen so they can't get hit. MMO means massively multiplayer online. So it's like, you know, World of Warcraft, Final Fantasy 14, Elder Scrolls Online, those kind of games. Neverwinter, I think, or whatever it is. Alex, thank you. Alex with another 50 stars. He's like, oh my god, it's Russell Crowe. It is. Be right with you, my friend. Thank you again, brother. Holy shit. Oh, goodness. Oh, that sucks, doesn't it? Alright, let's press the... Just let me get out of here very quickly, Alex, if you don't mind. Oh my gosh! See, if these green abobos get you, it's like almost one-hit death. This is totally nuts. Oh, dude, come on! Alright, come on. One more time, Rico. Oh, we got him. Kevin says you got Diablo 3 for the Switch. So, Alex, I'm going to find Russell Crowe for you. Where is Russell Crowe? Here we go. Oh my god, it's Russell Crowe!
Oh my god, it's Russell Crowe! Oh my god, it's Russell Crowe!
Why don't you go flush yourself down a toilet, you cunt?
Thank you again. How are all my friends on YouTube doing, by the way? Everyone here on YouTube still? Hope you guys are all comfortable and happy. Hey, when you asked zero divided by zero was, oh my gosh, that was nuts, wasn't it? Now, we just got another supporter notification, guys. Let me see what that is. It doesn't always come up. I do apologize about that. That's all right. Show's going to go on here. All right, let's continue with this bad boy, huh? Oh, black screen. Sorry, guys. This is going out to you. Thank you, Alex. Alex with the 50 stars. Sorry about that. I'm just going all over the... Oh, dude. There's so much to follow sometimes. Honestly, I just... Oh, man, I really need an assistant sometimes. It's so hard to keep up with everything by yourself, man. Thank you, screens, multiple chats, the game. I don't know how D-Wayne does it, because I'm always fucking up and making mistakes. All right, we got this. There you go. I'm getting a little bit disheartened here. I need to snap out of it. Yeah, this is part 4, Drew. Alright, there we go. We're gonna come back here, guys. We're gonna come back strong. Get Jessica Alba to be my assistant. We probably wouldn't get a whole lot of work done. Although, I'm not gonna go into that, actually, because I could probably get myself in trouble. my goodness. So, Theron says you play Fallout? Yeah, Fallout's a great game, isn't it? Which Fallout's your favorite, if you don't mind me asking? Maybe we could do New Vegas one day. You know, I've owned New Vegas for years and I've never played it. It's just always been sitting there waiting for a rainy day. John with another 185 stars. Thank you, man. Appreciate ya. Thank you so much. And what are we going to give to... I'm going to find something here for John. What do we got for John this time? We're going to go traditional this time, brother. Then there's mod. And then there's mod. And then there's mod. A little bit of arm taunting for Mystical Ninja. I'm trying to remember the Mystical Ninja game. Have we done Mystical Ninja on the channel before? I think we have. Well, what console's Mystical Ninja on again? Just... Oh, wait. Mystical, Yeah, what... Can you remind me about Mystical Ninja? I've forgotten about it. I think we have done it. I'm just trying to remember what it is. How you going there, Eli? Welcome to the stream. Thank you very much for coming by, brother. How's everything, alright? So Oscar says Fallout New Vegas is actually a top 10 game all time for him. Wow, that's giving me confidence to try it one of these days. I think the thing is, Fallout has a really loyal fan base. And I think if I start a Fallout game and I don't know what I'm doing, no one's going to let me hear the end of it, you know what I mean? So that's something to think about as well. You watched the episode of Golden Girls this week. It's funnier than you remembered. It's so much funnier now than when we were kids because we understand all the adult jokes. Oh, that's a way. I'm happy to hear, Eli. Nice. Eli says he's just chilling for the night. Chilling like a villain. So Christopher says, do we do Shinobi? Yeah, I usually play Shinobi 3 every couple months. We'll do Shinobi 3 eventually as well. Oh, gosh. Buy sandals to walk fast. Yeah, what? Yeah, I just realized Bimmy's got no shoes on. I'm pretty sure it's not safe to walk in all these areas, especially in an industrial area without boots. But yeah, Jimmy's got no shoes on. So it's not the best decision he's ever made in his life, huh? I played a little Fallout 4. I didn't get all that far in it. And I played some Fallout 3 as well. No New Vegas. I tell you what, Fallout 3 was annoying. That was a bit slow going to get started. But once you got started, it was pretty sweet. All those unskippable cutscenes at the beginning of Fallout were just like, really? I think if I did Fallout 3, everyone would leave before the game got to the point. It took you 200 hours to beat Fallout 3. That game is pretty big, huh? Yeah, I'm gonna get those too. I've always wanted to try them. Oh, you missed your stars for Steve Irwin. Sorry, Alex. Thank you very much again for the stars. Absolutely. Crikey! Alex, thank you again for the 50 stars. Sorry I missed that, man. I don't mean to be so slack. And Dave says it was the NES and Super Nintendo. What was, Dave? And here we go. So we got about 4 levels left in this bad boy. So as I said, we got 4 levels left in this. And then we're going to do our Sumbish bonus game, guys. Oh, gosh. Oh, boy. And then Tommy says, you think there should have been a Double Dragon crossover with the Ninja Turtles? That would have been a nice mixture. Well, they did mix Double Dragon with Battletoads. I think that's the closest you're going to get. How you going there, Brian? Good to see you, by the way. Thank you for coming in. I just saw your comment fly by there, man. If you can copy and paste for me. Thank you, brother. Good to have you today. I don't have the PS4 version. I'm playing the Switch version today, so that ain't gonna happen, unfortunately, Drew. I know the game, Matt, but I've never played it myself, bro. John, hey, we got Sodash here. You say you haven't played Double Dragon in years? Oh, so you're practicing a couple Mario hacks today? Okay, nice. Good luck with that, brother. Hope it all goes well. Wait, Double Dragon was on Street Fighter as well? I don't even remember that. Was that really a thing? Oh, dude. I don't like getting my ass kicked. It's gonna start making me incredibly angry. Ugh. Yeah, no worries, Black Eagle. You too, man. Have a great sleep, huh? Appreciate you coming. Oh, gosh! Just stop killing me! Oh, man, the rage is gonna totally come out. This game is starting to exhaust me because I hate losing. You're not supposed to have arcade difficulty in a lounge room beat-em-up. Why? Because I said. And there you go. Alex with another 100 stars. You thought I'm missing so many stars today. It is... Oh, gosh. Alex, thank you, brother. It's gone out to you, sir. Now, I've got a massive shout-out going out to Bryant as well, who's now been a supporter for 3 months. Thank you very much for everything you do, brother. Appreciate you. Thank you, Alex. Alex with the 50 stars or 100 stars, because I keep fucking missing them. Thank you, Alex. Oh, goodness. Baron Corbin was in Madden 12. Yeah, I saw that video on WrestleMania the other night. I watched the same video. Baron Corbin was a featured character in Madden 12. How about that? Under his real name, of course. There we go, we made it. Yeah, so Alex says, all I need to do is get the Chrysogrim and everything's going to be okay. Chrysogrim makes everything in life okay, brother. Absolutely. Makes everything all better. Yeah, I remember that. Oh, damn it, I wasn't paying attention. Yeah, I remember the Double Dragon cartoon. I never really watched it, though. I was so excited when Double Dragon announced that they were finally making a motion picture, and it sucked. So what else is happening, guys? Any other news for this late night? Starting to get a bit late here at OneCoin. I think we're approaching about 12 a.m. on the East Coast. So thank you for staying up with us, guys. For your late night pleasure. That's what she said. Finding a Bobo in an elevator, what's worse than that? Yeah, I know, right? Dude, come on. Oh, here we go, another credit. It's just, it gets a little bit claustrophobic with the amount of dudes you have to fight at once sometimes, huh? You think the Street Fighter movie sucked in a good way? Yeah, I put the Street Fighter movie in it's so bad it's good territory. But a lot of people don't agree with me. I thought it was so bad that it was good. Jason says you're glad that the holidays are over. I'm sorry to hear, bro. You know, the holidays are hard for some people, hey? I have to admit, the holidays were a little bit hard for me this year. Because, you know, usually over the holidays I'm DJing and around a lot of people. You know, I've retired. I'm not really keeping in touch with them anymore. And, you know, I obviously became single just before the holidays. And, you know, which is no big deal. But then you didn't have a significant other for the holidays. And, I tell you what, I was very, very fortunate to have some quality time with my family. Otherwise, it would have really sucked. But, you know, the holidays are hard sometimes, you know. So I have a lot of empathy for people who are down in the holidays. But we're in 2020 now, guys. Onwards and upwards from here. I'm sure we're all going to have an amazing year. Look at it from a... Hey, guys, we've got a... Okay, you know what? We're going to do a big shout-out to Black Lion Gamers. Travis, thank you very much for coming in. A very, very, very happy new year to Black Lion Gamers, guys. Now, I highly recommend... If you haven't seen Black Lion Gamers, check it out. We got two really, really awesome Mortal Kombat streamers in the community. Obviously, our boy Dwayne Headblock Gaming. But the other guy is Black Lion Gamers. You guys have probably seen him. We raid his page all the time. But guys, please make sure you check out Black Lion Gamers, Travis's stream, especially if you're into Mortal Kombat 11. He won't let you down, guys. He's absolutely awesome. Travis, thank you so much for coming in. And brother, how is your 2020 going so far? Hope you're well. I'm glad to finally speak to you, man. It's been a minute. There we go. As you can see, Travis, there's a lot of regulars here that know exactly who you damn well are. How you going, Ryo? We got Ryo over on YouTube. Good to see you. Yeah, Double Dragon 4 on the Switch. You better believe it, my friend. This came out about 2 years ago. Oh gosh, there we go. I think this is the final boss of this level, I think. Got E 8-bit E Honda sumbish, which I'm trying to beat. It's kind of weird saying 2020. Yeah man, we're in the roaring 20s now, huh? It's hard to believe that the 20s were like 100 years ago now. It's pretty crazy, huh? You wish the Switch dropped the price? I mean, you're probably gonna get this cheaper. Give me 1 second. Have I played Contra Rogue Corps? What do I think? Dwayne, and then Travis says he's finally free, brother. Man, you know what? You can't put a price at being at peace in your life, Travis. So I'm really happy for you. Man, you can't put a price on having peace. Having peace is the most important thing for a man, I think. Happy to hear it, brother. How was my New Year's? Up and down. Like, I spent the New Year's with the Sumbish Army, and we all had a really, really good time here. What did we play over New Year's again, guys? We did a whole bunch of games. And, and we did Beat It or Eat It as well. On the personal side of things, it's a little bit wishy-washy at the moment, but I'm working on that very hard, so... yeah. Up and down, but more positive and good, my friend. I've got nothing to complain about. Not too much. And Chris just told me to go F myself. Well, here we go, Chris. You're going to grab yourself a permanent ban. And we will never have to see you again. So that's a solution for you, Chris. Thank you very much for coming in. It's a shame you couldn't be a decent human. Maybe you'll learn one day. And we're going to carry on with the stream. Sorry about that, guys. Hey, Clifford, good to see you. Thank you, Drew, by the way. I don't want you to think I missed your comment, sir. There we go. We're going to take on these Malina bishes here. And then Byron says you kind of wish they'd bring the side-scrolling fighting games back. There's a ton of them. A really, really, really good side-scrolling beat-em-up is a game called Fighting Rage. You can get that on Switch, PS4, and on Steam. And that's probably one of the most fun ones that are out at the moment. And probably the one I'd recommend, at least until Streets of Rage 4 comes out. There's also a really cheap game called 99 Vitas, which you can probably pick up for $1. And that's actually not a half-bad beat-em-up either for the price, so... yeah, check out Fight and Rage, and check out 99 Vitas. They're pretty good games. Matt with the 50 stars. Thank you, Matt. Can he play the end credits theme? Mate, you know, it's good. Okay, Matt, first of all, we're going to do this for you. Matt. And Jesse, I'll get right with you, man. Let me just answer some questions. Matt, the reason we don't play the Mortal Kombat theme is because Facebook flags it and gets us in trouble. So, I appreciate you, Matt, wanting us to get in trouble, but the reason we don't play it is because we're not allowed, not because we just can't be bothered. You know, we get flagged for music, so we've got to be careful. It's more than just not wanting to play it, dude. Tyler says, do I wear a bandana everywhere I go? Nah, just when I entertain. It was my trademark when I used to DJ. And it's now my trademark for it's now my trademark for the live streaming. You know, it's just so I look different to everywhere else, you know? But, you know, I hate the sheep mentality. Oh, what are you wearing a bandana for? Oh, you shouldn't wear a bandana. That's just a sheep mentality on what people think should be normal. I think if you're an entertainer, you need to have a trademark that sets yourself apart so you seem different to everyone else. And this is my trademark. So, for example, if someone one day goes to his friend, oh, look, I saw this really awesome streamer, and he was playing all these retro games. He was awesome. And that person's friend might be like, well, what was his name? And that other person might be like, oh, I don't know. And then their friend might be like, well, what did he look like? And then that person might be like, oh, he had a headband. And then the other person might be like, oh, that's one coin only. So it helps you to easily get more recognized as well. You know what I mean? Jake, you have a good one, brother. Thank you very much. You'll get flagged for the one coin theme. No, we're talking about the Mortal Kombat theme, not the one coin theme. The one coin tune is my own. How you going, Snaggletooth? Thank you so much. I just had someone come in here and tell me to F myself, so it was like, bye, Felicia. That's all. No big deal. Yeah, so it's your signature, you know, that's all it is to it. Nothing else crazy. I'm hoping we pick the right door here now. Thank you, Jay. If I've missed any questions or comments, guys, please just comment again. I don't mean to be rude or anything. I remember when I used to DJ and I'd wear the bandana, my boss used to give me a hard time for it. He'd be like, you know, Rick, I don't think you should wear the bandana. And I was just like, man, why can't I just be myself? What's a big fucking deal? Anyway. Yeah, we got these sumbitches. Come on, Rick, one more. I wish I could use a safe state here because I always forget which door to go through, but I think we need to go in this right-hand side. Oh, it happened, Shane. I mean, I don't know what I've done to hurt anyone, but, you know, it is what it is. We'll just move on. Jason says that I end up punching my boss in the dick. No, I mean, most of the people I work for in the DJ industry are very well connected with maybe some people that would make me swim with the fishes if I did any dick punches to the higher-ups, so I'd probably should refrain from the aforementioned dick punches. Yeah. Anyway, I said too much. Well, that's kind of you, Alex. I appreciate that. But as I said, I don't know what people have to be jealous of. I'm just a sumbish with a video game controller at the end of the day. You know, it doesn't matter if you've just started streaming or you've been streaming for 10 years. We're all the same at the end of the day. You know, the only difference is a couple extra followers on a follow account. You know, like, doesn't make you better than anyone else. So dick punches. Well, it depends who it is to, I guess, Josh. Yeah. Oh, thank you, Shane. I appreciate it. As I said, I just pretty much only wear this when I entertain. I have left the house with it on a couple times, but, you know, it is what it is. Richard says we're all family here at OneCoin. Absolutely. Like, I'll explain it to you like this, Raj. Like, a lot of people don't get what it's actually like behind the scenes. Like, they think we've all got it made, and, you know, it's absolutely amazing, but it's not like all rainbows and lollipops like people think it is, you know what I mean? Anyway. Bobo's pissed off. This is the second last level, by the way, guys. I kind of, like, spaced out there for a second. I was just totally concentrating. I'm back now. Can you download these games on the Switch Lite? Absolutely you can. This is a digital game. Oh, Alfonso, bro, I still struggle to handle it, you know what I mean? Like, occasionally we'll get, like, a 10,000 star donation here and there, and man, it just means the world to me that someone would think that what I do is worth that kind of coin. Like, that's just, like, the biggest compliment ever, you know what I mean? You know, it doesn't matter who you are, everyone works hard for their money, and I mean, if you're... Yeah, I just appreciate it, you know? How you going, Jeffrey? Good to see you, man. Thank you for coming in. Good night to you too, Key. Thank you again for coming in. All right, we're on our final credit here. I think we can get to the final level, and then we're going to have to use a continue. And Shane says it's a price of fame. Oh, man, I mean, I'm just a small fish in the grand scheme of things. That's the even scarier bit, you know? I'm just very small fish at the end of the day. I'm gonna jump on this sumbitch. There we go. Come on, Rick. We did it. This is about as far as you got playing as a Bobo. Yeah, you can use all the other characters in this game as well, guys. But I just like to use Bimmy because I couldn't get a feel for the others. Oh, damn, really? Oh, come on. That sucks a fat one. Are you serious? Oh, dude. All right, let's try again. Alex says he remembers when he first saw me stream over 2 years ago. You watched because you love Zelda. And you... Oh, thank you, Alex. So, what games are your favorite that we play on the channel, by the way? Like, apart from Zelda, what other games do you like to see? Do you have, like, any preference or anything? I'm curious. Hey, how you going? We've got my former roommate Kelly in here, guys. Good to see you. Aslan says hello, everybody. Everyone in here remembers Aslan, of course. Good to see you, Aslan. I miss you, little guy. How you doing, Rumi? I hope you're okay. Thank you for coming in. We're just doing our third stream of the day. I've been pretty busy. How you keeping, Rumi? How's the new house? I'm always going to, like, call you Rumi forever now. You do know this. It's kind of, yeah. Do you guys think we have Alfonso, going back on that, do you guys think we have a good balance of old and new games, or do you think it should sway in a certain direction, or... I feel like most of the new stuff that we play is still nostalgic. Like, for example, we do a lot of new games, but, like, the new games is, like, a Marvel game, or, like, Mortal Kombat 11, or a Resident Evil game. Like, it still resonates with the childhood, you know what I mean? But, yeah, I mean, I'm happy to hear your feedback. I'm going to actually die on purpose here, guys. And we're going to use a continue. So just give me a little second. And don't forget, as soon as this is done, guys, we're going to load up our bonus game as well. So we just... This is the final level, but I'm going to have to go to the main screen and do a level select. Kelly says, Aslan is napping on the coffee table. New house is fine. You still need to come visit. Yeah, I'm going to look at getting a new set of wheels this year. Oh, good to hear you're doing well. How many roommates you got at the moment? You just living with one girl still? Right, here we go. So we're just going to exit the game, and then we're going to do the level select, guys. So give me a second here. 9, 10, 11, 12. There we go. Back to number 12. Bimmy. All right, so let's go do this final level. I've never beaten level 12 with all the credits that you're allocated. I've only ever gotten up to this, so... Dude, really? Oh, dude, I'm so sorry, James. Man, that's a big-ass story, bro, but I read as much of that as I could. So yeah, you flipped out and you had to leave, man. Bro, you've got to pay your bills and eat at the end of the day, you know what I mean? You can't work for so little money. I can't believe that people can get away with paying you so little over there. It's nuts, bro. Mind you, there's a lot of people that do the dodgy like that over here too. It's not documented as much, but you'll like to get backpackers over here, and you'll get some of the fruit pickers get paid absolutely nothing over here. You hear stories like that all the time. Oh, dude! Oh gosh, this is nuts! What the hell are these things doing? I don't even know what that magic spell's supposed to be. There we go. Oh, dude. Oh my gosh. This level's difficulty just went balls to the wall out of nowhere, huh? Come on, we can get these sumbishes. Oh, that's one. Come on, we gotta be close to this sumbish. Oh, that's okay, Alex, man. I remember that game. Again, I try to be... I mean, that's nowhere near as close to the worst game we've ever been asked for on Whatever Wednesday, Alex. Don't even worry about it, man. I know that game means a lot to you. I remember you telling me. Thank you, James. James, you have yourself a good rest, hey? Thank you again for everything, brother. I'm glad you still enjoy what we do after all this time. There we go, we got the original Double Dragon theme now. That's when you know that shit's almost over. That's not fair, we've got like the Bish twins here and they're shooting guns at me. I mean, nobody got time for that. Matt sent 50 stars. Oh, I'm sorry, Matt, thank you very much, guys. The comments at this time are still going a million miles an hour. Matt, thank you, brother. Matt, this one's going out to you. Again, thank you for letting me know that I've been missing stars. Don't forget to bring a towel! Alex with the 50 stars as well. Thank you very much, Alex. This one's going out to you.
Bring a towel. There he is. Be sure to bring a towel so you don't get all...
And Jared with 100 stars. Jared, thank you, brother. There we go. We got 3 donations in a row. It's freaking Haley's comment here. Yeah, I'm doing a bonus game, Theron. Absolutely. Thank you so much for all those stars, guys. Really, really appreciate that. Man, that's a lot of freaking stars, huh? Thank you, guys. As I said, they all add up. That's tremendous. You're just going to say the original Shaq Fu and Kazam. Well, there you go. I actually owned Shaq Fu when I was a kid. In 1995, I think it was either 1995 or 1996, PlayStation stuff was becoming popular. So the video store was like clearing out all the Sega Genesis titles. And I ended up getting Shaq Fu for about $15 or $20 ex-rental. And I was pretty happy to have it because obviously I couldn't afford Street Fighter 2 back then. So I was just happy to have a fighting game in my collection. So when I was a kid, I kind of enjoyed Shaq Fu. And then I play the game now and I'm like, what the hell was I thinking? Anyway, Shaq and a fool, yeah. Yeah, I used to have Shaq Fu on the Sega Genesis. James is sorry. No, you're fine, James. I appreciate hearing from you, man. I just try to read them as much as I can. There we go. Oh, kill me once and for all. Kill you softly. Just playing out these end credits. 2 people sent 50 more stars. Did they really? No, there we go. Oh, we got Russell Crowe again. So Alex sent 50 stars. And Crystal sent 50 stars as well. I'm so sorry, guys. As I said, these comments are going so quick today. It's nuts. It's oh, man. Thank you. There we go. I'm going to give these ones to you guys. And there they go, that's for Crystal, and we're going to do this one for Alex. I'm sorry, I thought this was America. Here you go, Alex. Thank you again, brother.
I thought this was America. Huh? Isn't this America? I'm sorry, I thought this
Matt
was
said,
America.
Yeah, Matt, you just asked me questions that I don't know how to answer. Anyway, blah, 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 blah. Here we go. The game is finished. All right, now we're going to do our bonus Mario game. So let me just turn all this off very quickly. And transfer to the next game. As I said, there's a lot to handle on this, so I'll just, we're gonna load this sumbish up. and we're going to load this sumbish up. And hopefully this will all work straight away. To answer your question, we pay taxes in Australia. And, there's penalties over here, as you'd expect, just like the IRS. I think the Australian tax office is probably a little bit more forgiving than what the American tax office is. I hear what goes on over there, and, like, they don't take any prisoners, right? Jason with the 50 stars, you got it, man. Thank you, Jacob. Jason, sorry. Damn it, I can't get things right today. This is going out to you, my brother. Alright guys, again, thank you for coming in. As our bonus game today, we are playing Super Mario Land in glorious color. So I might just need to reload this because the program actually just had a boo-boo here. So let me just reload this one more time. Again, juggling a lot, guys. Appreciate the patience and the love. We're going to go to... where's the recent files? Here it is. There you go. I'm stressing myself way too much. Rick, take a chill pill. It's not a big deal, mate. Well, if I had a chill pill, I would have taken it already. All right, here we go. Let's start this sumbish. Now, let me know how the sound is. I want to make sure it's comfortable for everyone. This is the Game Boy Mario in color. It is. Something nice and different. I've only done this a handful of times. You asked if a streamer plays their own music, they don't get flagged for it. Correct, Matt. We're not going to get flagged for our own music. See, I play my own music. For example, my intro on One Coin Only is my own creation. They're not going to flag me for it because it's mine. You think it looks so weird in color? It's a bit different, huh? But yeah, this is our bonus game. Thought we'd chuck this on as a surprise. I'll do this as a proper stream in the future again, too. You know, this will take us about 30 to 40 minutes to beat. Oh, really, Jacob? Oh, so Dominic says you're working at Blockbuster Video when Conker's Bad Fur Day came out. Yeah, I mean, I saw Conker's Bad Fur Day back in the day all over the TV, and I was like, this game looks phenomenal. And now I look at it and I'm kind of like, eh. I don't even enjoy playing it, to be honest. And Crystal's like, Rick, you really need to calm your farm. That is some good advice, my friend. Thank you. Speaking of good advice, my advice to everyone here is to like the stream if you haven't already. Thank you very much. And we're only 2 shares away from 100 as well, guys. So if you know anyone that wants to watch, whether it's your brother, your sister, the milkman, the fireman, the candyman, especially the firemen right now, big shout out to them, obviously. Give them some entertainment to watch. Rick Rage Trigger, lost files and aren't even lost. Well, I mean, there's... I get triggered pretty easily. Hey, it's a phenomenon that scientists are still trying to figure out. Oh, there we go. We made it. And then Jeffrey says, "Do I still use a cell phone to record?" No, not anymore. I haven't phone streamed in a long, long time. But you know, there's nothing wrong with getting started that way, especially if you're on a budget. Now we're up to 106 shares now. Thank you so much, guys. That's it. Boom, we made it. It sucks. There we go. So, Alex, for hookers and blow. Thank you, Alex. Maybe in 6 months, I will go on a small vacation again. And I'll make sure when I go on vacation in 6 months, those 50 stars go towards some hookers. There have to be a pretty good exchange rate to get a hooker for 50 stars, but you know what? I'll be thinking of you, Alex. I don't know what that means. No, I'm just messing. Alex, thank you so much. This is going out to you. Thank you, James. Oh, gosh. Thank you, man. Really, really appreciate you. Fiji water is very good water. Well, there you go. My brother-in-law's dad lives and works in Fiji. I haven't been there myself yet. Oh, gosh. 50-50, man, can you... Oh, gosh, I'm not going to go there. I'll get myself in so much trouble. Mind you, the women and children are asleep now. It is One Coin After Dark, but... No, I'll behave myself for the time being. Oh, gosh. As I said, I may come on with a late night stream. I'm not sure yet, guys. I kind of do just want to chill out a bit after this one. Watch some SmackDown. After that, I'll see how I'm feeling. But to everyone who's come in today, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed the streams. And Deadpool was a lot of fun. That was a lot more fun than I was expecting. I'm glad you guys liked it today. And alright, there we go. We got this one. Jeffrey says, Ricky, I hope you're not in the fire area. Bro, I'm not going to lie. The fires are really serious over here. In my state, we don't have too many problems at the moment. But man, it's very dry here right now. There's a lot of bush. We're basically living in a barbecue. It's scary times. But no, I appreciate your well wishes, my man. Big shout out going out to all the brave firefighters taking care of this bullshit, huh? There you go, and we'll just leave that one there, James, but you're spot on. Oh, we got a raid from Mr. G. Mr. G, thank you so much. Appreciate that. Welcome aboard. How you doing there, Mr. G? Don't forget to check out Mr. G, aka Gil and your travels, guys. Thank you, Brian. Appreciate that. Alex says, since it's one coin only after dark, can you say your favorite Aussie joke? Yes, you can, Alex, but tread very carefully because you have an Australian in here. Oh, is that really? John, I didn't even know that. We'll have to check that out one day. I'm glad you're doing well, man. We miss you around these parts. Yeah, we don't want to get too political. I will say one thing, and it doesn't matter what your political position is. I think everyone will agree on this. Stay the fuck off Twitter. Like, okay, when you do something, you've done something. But when you jump on Twitter, man... Just don't go on social media afterwards. Jeez, man, like, that's just poking the bear at the zoo, you know what I mean? But apart from that, no, I'm not going to talk about politics. We're a neutral zone here, guys. Alright, we got this. Oh, there you go. What's an Australian kiss? It's a French kiss. Just down under. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You don't know how to Twitter? I don't really use Twitter either. Twitter's big in the United States. Twitter's not really that big in Australia. Yeah, fair enough. As I said, it's all subjective, and I'm sorry. I don't like to talk about politics. I very much sit on the fence with that stuff because, you know, I like to keep one coin neutral. But yeah, we'll just let that go and we'll move on. I probably said too much and I do apologize. And then Jeffrey says, what's with the bandana? Am I a ninja? I've mentioned a few times, say, this is a trademark, you know, this is my way of standing out. Because, you know, again, at the end of the day, like, I was a DJ, there was a bazillion DJs out there. How am I going to get people to remember my name as a DJ? Look different to everyone else. Same with streaming, there's so many streamers out there. How am I going to get people to remember OneCoin? Look different to everyone else, you know, that's kind of how I look at things in the entertainment industry. You like getting hugs from bears? Yeah. As I said, I just think we should all learn how to get along, hey? We're all grown adults here. Well, I'm kind of like 39 going on 15, but so I'm not really using myself as a good example, but everyone else is a grown adult. You saw where Peyton Royce tweeted that she was thankful that her family and many others escaped that bushfire. Yeah, Peyton Royce is from Melbourne, I think, and I think Melbourne and Sydney is where the biggest problems are at the moment. Every state's been suffering, but especially in Melbourne and New South Wales at the moment, I think. Oh, thank you, Dominic. Appreciate ya. See, I'm glad to know that my style choice made a slight difference. I don't really have much swag or anything, but chuck on a headband, you're in like Flynn. By the way, Errol Flynn is the greatest Australian ever to be an Australian, I'm just saying. In like Flynn. Isn't that just the best saying in the whole world? In like Flynn, I love that. We all know why that saying's around too, by the way. Hey, how you going, Sean? Welcome to the stream. Thank you for coming in. Glad you're back. And how was your shift? Don't forget to follow the page if you're new, by the way, guys. I just sent a little notification there. And did I hear that Liv Morgan and Lana might actually be in... No, Raj, that's nonsense. They're not in a real-life relationship. Rusev and Lana are actually together. I'm actually wondering if Lana and Rusev are still a happy couple. Put it this way. I'm not a controlling guy, but I have very, very strict old-fashioned boundaries. And if my woman was suggested to be in a storyline where she's making out and doing all sorts of stuff with another dude in my company on stream, I'd be like, forget it. There is no way I would tolerate that. If I was married to Lana and she's like, okay, I'm gonna start kissing and pashing Bobby Lashley in a storyline, I'd be like, okay, that's fine, bye Felicia. So, I mean, I don't know how Rusev tolerates that, to be honest, but, you know, it is what it is. I'll be like, bye Felicia, no thank you. How you going, Rolando? Lynn like Larry, no, it's Larry Flint, you think, isn't that who you're talking about? Maybe I'm overthinking it, I don't know. I mean, I know acting's acting, but wrestling, I think, is a bit different to acting. Oh, dude, that didn't work out. I mean, this is starting to get a bit tricky now. Hold up, wait a minute. Oh, did they really? I had no idea. That's interesting. Oh, there you go. Liv Morgan and... Oh, dude! The controls in this are a little bit slippery. Bear with me, guys. I'm going to save from here. We'll get through this eventually. Oh, that was hard. There we go. We got him. You think $500,000 paychecks help them to... Oh man, it's more to life than just money, hey. I just don't know how Rusev handles that, hey. And it must be awkward. To be fair on Bobby Lashley, it must be awkward for him too. Like, honestly. Good night to you too, Jesse. Thank you for coming in. Oh, thank you, Jesse. You have a good night too, hey? Always appreciate you hanging out and having a good time with us. Hope you're, No distracting you this time, yeah. And then Jeffrey says, what kind of PC do you have? Do you need a PS4? What's that for? Sorry, my friend, for... You do need a pretty middle to high-end computer in order to stream. You do need the processing power, Jeffrey. You think Bobby's loving it? Bobby's just Mac, yeah, maybe. I don't know. Oh, here we go, guys. We're almost halfway through this game now. I really like this in color. What do you guys think? It looks really cool. That didn't work out for us, did it? So Jeffrey says, what CPU do I have? I have an i7 650, I think. 16 gig of RAM, a GTX 6 gig 980 video card. Or was it 979, you know, GTX 970 or 80 or whatever it is, 6 gig. The computer was pretty good 3 years ago, and it still runs most games that I play on Ultra, but it is time for an upgrade, because I've been running this full-time for 3 years, and I'm starting to have a few problems with it, so it's getting pretty close to have an upgrade. Oh no, Jacob, this isn't released on the Game Boy This isn't released on the Game Boy Color, my friend. What capture card do I use? I use an Elgato HD 60 HDS or whatever it's called. So just your mid-level capture card, runs pretty well. Do I have Windows 10? No, I'm running on Windows 8.1 still, believe it or not. But my next computer I'll run Windows 10. Sorry guys, I just had to... It was really, really hard to get all that out while I was concentrating on the game. I was trying to multitask. See, I'm not like Jessica on the kitchen again, who has the phone, who has a baby, who has a saucepan, who has the oven. I can't do that. Alright guys, we're halfway through. We've got about 6 levels left. Jeffrey says you're using an older PC too. This PC is still a beast, but considering I got it 3 years ago, but you know, the video's out of date now. It's not industry standard video anymore. That's alright, I'm pretty excited though. I'm still deciding whether to get a new PC or to get a gaming laptop. Because, you know, I do like to travel a lot, so maybe a really good gaming laptop would be the way to go, but we'll see. I was thinking of getting an Acer Predator. Does anyone in here own an Acer Predator? Like to know some thoughts on that one. Oh, dude, that was close, wasn't it? Come on, Rick, get out of there. Oh, that was close as well, jeez. Yeah, I know what you mean. Matt says he wishes I could play the Spotify music when I stream, but unfortunately there's rules, brah. There's copyright laws, my man. No, you're right, James. James, I love that you're hanging around more often, but I understand you need your beauty sleep, sir. Computers are like cars, aren't they? Exactly. But let's be realistic, Kevin. If you buy a really, really good gaming computer, as long as you don't need to have every single bell and whistle, you're going to be able to keep it for 4 or 5 years, man. Like, it's just... You know, unless you're like a... You need to have the latest technology all the time. I mean, it'll last for 4 or 5 years. That's how I look at it anyway. I mean, this computer's still running just fine, but I want to get another one before it's too late. There we go, we did it. Oh, damn, that didn't work out. Oh, okay, Jason says he has an Acer laptop, just not the Predator one. Okay. Odd. Yeah, if I got a gaming laptop... Apparently, the Acer Predator is, like, same specs as, like, Alienware, but way cheaper. Man, see, at the end of the day, I just want to be able to stream and play games. I don't understand what people are achieving when they keep upgrading every 6 months. Nor do I know where they're getting the money. Which is not my business anyway. No, I understand, Jason. The only thing that concerns me about getting a gaming laptop as well is the cooling. Like, gaming laptops can overheat. Yeah, there's loopholes. Again, if you're playing video games are, like, classed as fair use. So if you're playing copyrighted music in a video game, most of the time these stream pages will turn a blind eye because it's part of the video game. To a point. Like, I play GTA and I usually don't get flagged for GTA, to be honest. Sometimes the video will be partially muted, but only in the sections that are questionable. Can you stream for a laptop? Oh, I've already got a backup laptop. I've got a very low-end gaming laptop, and I can just pull off a stream when I travel. So when I'm in Thailand, for example, I've been using my laptop. But it's very low-end. I need more power, so that's why I'm looking at upgrading. And then I'll just keep that as a spare. What did Mario do for God to throw rocks at him? He'll have no fury like God throwing rocks at Mario, I guess. I don't know. Oh, dude, I miss that freaking mushroom. Oh, bull dust, really? That's an Aussie phrase right there. Ah, bull dust, mate. Oh, okay, I got you, Jeffrey. Yep, yep. And as I said, the controls on this make this game really hard. Oh, dude, see, there was a lag input as well. Like, fuck off. I tried to jump over that and he didn't. Mario, stop being such a dumbass. We gotta beat this freaking level, mate. As I said, as soon as this stream is done, guys, I'm gonna have a rest. I'm gonna watch SmackDown. I may come on for a late night stream or an early morning stream. Speaking of which, guys, I don't want you guys to all forget that our weekly Mario Kart stream is on at 7 p.m. tomorrow, guys, so hopefully you can join us for that. Supporters get priorities in the lobby as well. But if you want to pull out your Switches and race with One Coin Only himself tomorrow, don't forget we do this every week. Kevin says the streams I did on the laptop still looked okay. Yeah, I was really, really struggling to... It was, What I'm going to do is I'm going to buy a second green screen as well. And whenever I travel, I'm going to take a second suitcase and bring like a green screen and lights. And you guys are going to get the proper stream experience even when I travel. So you won't even... If I go to Thailand, for example, you won't even know that I'm there because you're still getting the same quality stream. So that's sort of what I'm working towards. As I said, I don't think I'll be back there in a while, but... No, that's okay, Jeffrey, you're fine, man. I can hardly put a sentence together right now. Well, everyone can tell when One Coin's getting tired because he can't put a coherent sentence together. Oh, dude. Get back on here. No, that's okay, Kev. We'll get you on one of these days, hey? I know, it's so hard to come on at a time that suits everyone, because we got awesome Sumbishes in here from all over the world, and I feel especially bad for my friends in the UK. Like, they've probably got the worst end of the stick. No worries, James. We'll see you again tomorrow, hey? Oh, I've got that game. I got that in the PSN special, but I haven't tried it yet, Jeffrey. Well, yeah, what do you think of Sniper Elite? Number 4, I like the third one. I played a lot of the third one back in the day. I thought that was actually a surprisingly good game. Really fun. Oh, so Jeffrey says he's in Albany, New York. Oh boy. We can't go in that sumbish. Oh, dude. No, I understand, Luke. You have a great day, too. Thank you again for coming in. Have a good sleep, my brother. As I said, we're going to be back, same back time, same back channel tomorrow. I need to work out what I'm doing tomorrow. After Mario Kart, I haven't planned anything yet. Work something out. It's very fun, yeah. You have all the... Oh, okay, gotcha, yep. I'm trying to work out whether to do a new game or an old game after, I don't know, man. So hard to plan a schedule for all these games all the time. I get streamer burnout sometimes, where even though I've got thousands of games, I never know what to play, you know what I mean? Oh, thank you, Captain BS. Appreciate ya. Good to see you still here, sir. Yeah, the version of Sniper Elite I played was on PS4. They had that remastered version or whatever. It's a shame because the online lobbies are always dead. You could never get a game. Jeffrey says, do I have a PS4? Absolutely, I do. We actually streamed off the PS4 earlier today. We did Deadpool, which was a lot of fun. I had a great time with that, actually, to be honest. So Vanessa says she has this game as well on the original Game Boy. I would argue that we just finished probably one of the hardest levels in the game. So, this last world should hopefully be alright. Sometimes it happens, Clifford, and, you know, some days I'm, you know, again, as I said, I work every day, and I've been doing this for a long time. So there's certainly some days that I don't always feel like streaming, but I feel like just pushing myself and making myself do it has helped with my discipline, so, it's kind of a, I've kind of won out in the end, I guess. Hey, how you going, Andrew? Thank you for coming in. Welcome to the stream, brother. You want to play together one of these days, Jeffrey? What kind of games do you like to play on the PS4? Yeah, I like the music in this one. This concept of Super Mario Land is interesting. Like, you know, Super Mario Land 2 feels a lot more like a regular Mario Brothers game. But this one kind of seems like it's in some kind of crazy parallel universe or something. I'll give you guys my PSN name. Let me type that in for you guys very quickly. Now, we just got another notification. There you go. That's my PSN name right there. And let me just check these notifications quickly, guys. What did we just get? Massive shout out to Generation Genesis Gaming. Andrew, our good friend. Who's now been a supporter for 11 months. It's almost our big one-year anniversary, my friend. Thank you so much for everything you do, Andrew. I really appreciate you, dude. What was I going to say? Oh, yeah, guys, don't forget, if you also want to become a supporter, you can click on the green shield. And absolutely no obligation, guys. But it's like the premium membership. And you can find out all the details just by clicking on it. So you don't have to worry about any secret like payment pages or anything like that, but just if you want to know more, Green Shield is available for you. And alright, let's go back in this sumbish. So Matt says if he was a streamer, he would play Megan 3 Stallion music and you'd get flagged. You would get flagged for a phone. You'd probably get demonetized and kicked off the platform, dude. And Drew says Ricky puts out at 1 year, bro. This time next year, if it's been that long without Nookie, I'll probably put out with anything with a heartbeat. No, I'm just kidding. That's a terrible joke. I was just trying to make you guys laugh. You don't have to worry about my sanity yet. And so Retro Storm, good to see you, Chris. Guys, we got Retro Storm Gaming in the house. Thank you for coming in. Yeah, as I said, in my state, so I'll explain to you how the Australia works. I live in Queensland, which is on the east coast. I live in Brisbane, which is like, where would you say Brisbane is? It's kind of like the center of the east coast, I guess, or maybe just a little bit further up than the center of the east coast. Under us, we have New South Wales. And under that, we have Victoria. That's where the majority of the fires are at the moment. So they're further south from where I live. So Queensland still copped it a bit over Christmas time. We're okay at the moment. But our brothers and sisters further south are not so lucky. Yeah, pretty much, Jason, huh? Thank you, Jeffrey. No worries, man. I'll get to it soon. Yeah, no, I saw that map too. I know exactly the one you're talking about. It's pretty accurate, dude. And Jacob says he's had no Nookie for a decade. Bro, I like Nookie, but I like Nookie. I don't like missing out on it. I mean, it's okay to go without it. It's not a bad thing. I just like it. Sorry. That's too much information. And then Jeffrey says, do I like Need for Speed Heat? Dude, I think the game is absolutely awesome, like from a mechanical side of things, but the story's not interesting and it makes it a little bit boring after time. Drew, thank you, man. Drew with another 150 stars. Thank you. And Chris with 250 as well. Once again, big shout out to Generation Genesis Gaming and Retro Storm Gaming. Thank you so much for the love, guys. And what are we going to give to you all today? Let me find something. Yeah, oh, this one. There you go. You're right. I guess you're right, Clifford. I don't have a right to complain. I'm sorry if I made anyone feel bad. Me and my big mouth, huh? I was only half joking anyway, guys. Don't take me too seriously. Thank you so much, guys. Mario probably has dusty balls. I know, because Peach just keeps taking advantage of him and she never gives him the cookie. Oh, damn. There you go. We're going to keep going here. Oh, gosh. Shane says, was I born and raised in Australia? Yeah, dude, I was. I was born in Brisbane, spent a year in New South Wales, then came back to Brisbane, then at the age of 11, I was pretty much spent most of my life on the Gold Coast until I was about... on and off from the Gold Coast until I was about 30, and then it's just been Brisbane ever since. Let me just reload here, guys. I'm getting a little bit stuck. Sorry. We gotta finish this, guys. Big Show and Val Venus, I know. I still remember seeing that when it actually aired. And I just thought it was the funniest thing. Oh, gosh. Yeah, I thought it was the funniest thing ever. Wakey, wakey, piss off, Snakey. There we go. We got this. Oh, my goodness, Chris. Dude, you don't need to send so many stars, brother. Oh, my man, thank you. Chris just sent a massive 1,200 stars. Chris says, he's hoping things stay well for you. Bro, just send your thoughts and prayers out to our firefighters and the people that are living in these areas. Honestly, I'm doing okay. I did a small part, and I donated a little bit today. Everyone has really come together in the country, whether it's to help out or whether to donate. And, you know, the sense of community has been awesome. But, no, Chris, thank you so much, man. That's amazing of you. Need for Speed Payback is a little bit mediocre. Same, I couldn't really get into Need for Speed Payback. Thank you so much, Chris. Awesome, awesome sauce. Sauce with a little extra awesome in it. I'm gonna get out of here soon. We're gonna finish off strong, Rick. Get it done. Get it done. I think there's a mushroom in here too. So this is where we died before, wasn't it? Oh, crap. I think there's... Oh, dude, really? Damn, patience, Rick! Patience, young... Freaking... Grasshopper, mother bitch. Alright, there we go. Which Mario is this? This is Super Mario Land 1, but we're playing the color version today. Playing the old color version. Oh, gosh. I'm pretty sure the star power is in this. This level is... Oh, dude, I missed the star power, really? Well, that sucks. Oh, no! Oh, my... Frickity! There we go. The rage is going to flow now, guys. The rage is going to... Fuckity, fuckity! Oh my gosh, get out of there! Dude! Oh yeah, no worries, Rick, just jump straight up in the fireball, you fucking wanker! Stop it! Oh my gosh! Come on, Rick, you gotta... Fuck! Fuckity! Oh my gosh, I've snapped. I've snapped. Oh, crappity, crap, crap! Oh, I'm gonna pause from here. Apparently our PM is being shady. Yeah, he kind of, I mean... Well, I I'm not going to talk about politics too much. Even if it is Aussie politics. One thing I will say is, I don't think he's necessarily done anything wrong, but he's not been a great leader either, you know what I mean? You know, I think leaders become a pillar of support for their community in times of crisis. And, you know, while our PM hasn't technically done anything wrong, he's not really been a great leader. And, I mean, it's just... Cat food sandwich. Oh, gosh. So what's my favorite thing to cook? Stop it, Retro Storm. I'm getting a lot of trolls about that lately. I get so many people come in, they're like, oh, you eat dog food for star donations. It's like, I did that one time for Beetle Eat It. I've done about 5 million streams since then. None of them involved eating dog food. we're a Commonwealth, so we have a Prime Minister. You guys are like a... I don't know what you call it in the United States, like a... like a republic or something? I don't know, something along those lines, you know. Our country has a Prime Minister, we're part of the Commonwealth. Forgive me, I'm not well educated. Hope I didn't say anything stupid. You begged me not to do that. It wasn't my finest moment, Retro Storm, I'm not gonna lie. Oh, you, democracy, of course, yes. That's right, democracy. Yeah, we're a democracy as well, of course, but we're a democracy under the Commonwealth. Yeah, Democratic Republic, that's the one. So there you go. Well, we'll leave this topic alone. Everyone's probably got a different name for it. This is the final level, by the way, guys. We're almost there. Jeez, this dragged on for a bit longer than I was expecting. I didn't expect to get as stuck as what I did in this one today. Now, I'm going to send you guys to another stream as soon as this one is done, guys, so don't go too far away. Oh. Thank you, Jeffrey. I'm just being my crazy ass self, dude. You'd be surprised, Jeffrey. Most Australians are just like this. You think I'm crazy, most of our people are crazier, actually. But they make good people to drink beers and have barbecues with. Just saying. Jason says, is there a level select on this game? There may be a code for it. But if there's a level select code on this, I have to admit, I don't know what it is. I'm not saying it doesn't exist. Jeffrey, yeah, maybe one day, brother. As I said, I'm going to be back in the United... One of my goals for 2020 is to come back to the United States and meet more of you guys. So, Jeffrey, you're 36. Yeah, man, I'm 39. Dude. Yeah, 39 years young, mate. Yeah, everyone tells me I need to have either Kansas or Texas barbecue, so... Hey, Tony, thank you, man. Tony's dropping the 100 stars. Guys, we nearly made 10,000 stars today. That's absolutely crazy. Thank you very, very, very much. We got really close. That's a big goal. Oh, here we go. I forgot this boss has two forms. So before we keep going, Tony, what can we give to Tony? I'm gonna give you this one.
This is blasphemy.
This is Sparta!
There you go. We don't use that screen often enough. That screen is awesome. Thank you again, brother. Pound a couple red horses. That'd be cool, bro. I've never had beer from the Philippines before. You can get Philippines beer in Australia, but it's really hard to get. Like, you're paying three times the price for it here because it's, like, it's a rare import, for whatever reason. There we go, we got it. Oh, Jeffrey, don't worry about that, brother. Again, there's absolutely no obligation on the stars. They're really, really appreciated. But, I mean, you know, you guys come in, you have a good time. That's all I can ask of you, really. Hey. And Matt says, 50 stars for Lakers win, 28-7 now. You got it, Matty. This is going out to you. What are we going to give to Matty this time? This one. Hey, Booker T.
Booker T, six-time world champ, two-time WWE Hall of Famer.
How you going there, George?
Just represent right now, One Coin Only. Hey guys, you can check out One Coin Only on Facebook right now. Do it! Do it now! They do it for you.
Thank you so much, King Booktor. I know, Victor. It's Victor, I hope you and your family are safe wherever you are, by the way, if you're suffering in the danger zones, my man. Prayers going out to you. Everyone in my friend circles made sure they donated. I know there's nothing I can physically do, but I hope every little bit helps out. I know it's a horrible, horrible, horrible situation. But guys, thank you so much for coming in. As I said, don't go too far. Thank you, Captain BS. I'm going to give a page out there a raid. How you doing there, Joshy? Good to see you. Also, guys, please don't forget to like on the way out, too. That's incredibly helpful. There's a website called Cameo where you can actually hire celebrities for shout-outs. So you just pay them some cash, and I'm not going to show off and be like, oh, I know Booker T. We go way back. I don't. I wish I did. That'd be totally awesome. But yeah, I don't really know anyone personally. Oh, I do. I mean, I've met some rappers and some famous DJs, but yeah, that's past tense. Jared with a $2 super chat. Thank you, Jared. This is going out to you. Thank you so much for everything you do, Jared. I appreciate ya. All right, guys, well, what I'm going to do, thank you for coming in. I'm not sure if I'm going to come on with a late night stream yet. I am going to go have a break and watch some SmackDown. It has been a pretty big day, but we got Southern Belle Gaming on. She's absolutely wonderful, guys. Please check out my friend Brittany. Go support her. She's such a big supporter of One Coin Only. How you doing there, cutie pie? If I don't see you guys again tonight, have a great sleep. We're going to have a big, fun Mario Kart day tomorrow. Otherwise, we may see you in the early hours. We'll see how we go. But thanks for being awesome, guys. You all take care of yourselves. And we'll be back soon, guys. Take care.